So in this video, I'm going to talk about Die Hard Arcade, which is a Sega Saturn game. Sega Saturn is the console that I own very first. This is my very first console to own for me. And Die Hard Arcade was actually the very first game that I bought along with it. And it became personally one of my most played games ever when I had it. I played it so much. I played this game so many times. You wouldn't even believe. And it's a pretty simple game. It's just an arcade port. If you played the arcade game, Die Hard Arcade, that's pretty much it. That's the Sega Saturn version. They just ported it over. There is no extra addition to it. The only extra addition is that, you know, in the arcade, you have to input a coin to continue when you die. In the Sega Saturn version, you don't have, since you can't put in the coins into Saturn system, which would be pretty cool if that was possible. But since you can't do that, you play this mini game before you start the game. In this mini game, you are a submarine. It's a 2D screen. You're a 2D submarine, and there's you're a 2D battleship, and there's submarines in the bottom of the sea, and you just keep playing. You drop mines and to destroy the submarines. The more you destroy, the more lives you get. And the submarine will shoot torpedoes up in the air, and you just have to dodge the torpedoes. That's a little mini game you play to get the credit to put coins. Now, if you play enough and get like 40 coins, that's usually enough to beat the whole game. And the game is, I really loved it, especially because it's a 3D beat 'em up. There's so many combos you can do. There's in the Sega Saturn controller, there's A, B, C, and A, B, and C. C is jump, I believe, and A is punch, and B is kick. So there's different combinations you can make with these three attacks. But then there's also more combination. If you get close to an enemy, get really close, then you grab the person. And there's more combos you can do with an A and B, and the C and B, and C and A, and all that. There's just really cool moves to make. There's a lot of fun items to use. The enemies are really fun to play. And in between the stages, there are these interactive kind of cutscenes, I guess, or quick time events. Which are really fun. And if you fail at a quick time event, that means you're running down and person comes out and the quick time event tells you to press the kick button. You miss it, the person you kick, you still kick, but the person dodges that kick, and then now you have to fight that person, and someone that person calls for backup, and you get an extra fight fighting arena on a stage. So that's really cool. There's a lot of different guys. There's different weapons, handguns, fire extinguishers, maze, a shower mop, a missile launcher. That's like the best weapon to get, because you get like 6 missiles in each shot. There's a humongous dude that comes with the missile launcher, and you hit him with the missile and he's still alive. But you know, when you have a missile launcher, you can fire it. You can also swing it. There's different combos you can make. It's a pretty unique system. The story is hardly there, but you get little cutscenes here and there. It really ties the story in together based on the movie. And the movie doesn't have that many cutscenes and dialogues anyway. So this makes a really perfect movie to game transition. And the best part, the reason why I played this game so many times is because you can play with another player. It's two playable. So co-op with this game is super, super fun. And when you, at the very last part, if you beat the game with your friend, there's also a section where you can do a versus. Your friend versus you, and that is, it's so much fun, you know, trying to do combos on your friend. And there's also a pull at this end, and the pull this end at the end. So if one of the person who's really good gets a pull, then it's game over for the other player, and you just keep playing again and playing again until the credits roll out. So it's one of my childhood memories with this game. I have so many great memories with Die Hard Arcade. It's being one of the very first game I've ever owned. You know, I played games before Die Hard Arcade. I played on consoles before Sega Saturn, but it was the very first game I've ever owned and played so many damn times. It's just really a fun game. It's a short experience. You can beat the game in like, what, an hour? Because of that, the summary minigame, you can have up to 99 credits. And with that amount, there's no way you can not beat the game. So you can beat the game in an hour, but if you keep playing it again and again and again, like I did, it will have a long-lasting replay value. But there is no actual replay value. The replay value is just that it's just so much fun to play with another friend over and over again. Of course, as time went on, I got more Sega Saturn games, so Die Hard Arcade wasn't the only game I played after that. But still, it's a really fun game that I really enjoy remembering.